So now let's talk about printing out to a file. And by the way, for both reading in and printing out, there are various ways of doing this. This is one way, and I've tried to pick kind of the simpler ways that we can then expand on if we want to. But public class, and this will be file out fun. Void main string. Args. All right, so to print out, we're going to need to access the java.io library again, and the file that we're after, or the method that we're after, is print writer. Okay. And when we get into those IO type classes, it might just be easier to say give us everything, because we start using a bunch of them, and so. You will get extra classes in there, but you could do that as well. Just put an asterisk, and that'll bring in everything. But if I want to print out to a file, I need to create a print writer object. And I can call this whatever I want. I'll just call it file out. And that's equal to a new print, new print writer object. And what goes inside the parentheses? Well, the parentheses are going to hold the name of the file and the location of the file that I'm going to be printing out to. So if I want to print out to my C drive examples folder, and I want to create a file called output.txt, that's the name of the file that's going out, or as I like to call it, output. Okay, I'm just going to leave it as that. But we can't leave the backslashes, because if we remember, let me go ahead and save this. If we remember, it's going to give us an error saying you can't do a backslash E. That's a bad escape character. Well, we didn't mean to do an escape character. We're just trying to put a backslash. So we'll do double backslashes so that it's escaping to a backslash. And then we'll get that file to my output .txt file. So now that I have that set up, I can write out to that just like I write out to my regular printer. Now, usually I'd say system.out.println and then print something. That will print out to the console, right? Well, if instead I refer to my print writer object, so I say file out dot. Now, just like I can do a print or print line or print f, any of that stuff that we've done, I can do a print line to the file out object and say, just printed some text to a file. Okay? So that's it. Let's try running this program. Okay, we're getting an error saying file not found exception. The problem here is that, again, we're trying to access a file. Now, what if that file output is not valid? I can't put that there. Or let's say the folder doesn't exist. That's probably more likely. Then this needs to be in a try catch, and so it wants me to just add a try. And then a catch, and what we're going to catch is the file not found exception that I'll name E, the object that's going to be passed to me, and then I'll just print out and say, sorry, not a valid file. What would be interesting is for somebody to go back and analyze how many times I hit the backspace key versus how many characters I type. I am a horrible typer, apparently. Okay, so cannot find symbol, file not found exception. That's because we need to import that. So import java.io.file not found exception. Okay, so save that. And now if I run this, the program runs and it seems like it did nothing. And in fact, it probably did do nothing. Let's go look and see. C drive examples. Excuse me. And there should be a file in there named output. There it is. Output.txt. If I double click on that, there's nothing in there. So this was not impressive at all. Well, the problem is I forgot one step. After we've written to the file, then we need to close it for writing. So I need to do a file out.close, which closes the file and does the writing, and the file's then not tied up by the program. And so if I compile and run this and try this again, then if I run this, then it says just printed some text to a file. Okay, so it's as simple as that. For printing out to a file, like I said, there's other ways of doing it, many of which are more complicated, but that's all it comes down to, is rather than printing out to the screen, we print out to the file. So I could do a print, and if I wanted to do a print instead of a print line, then I could say just print it out to a file. File out.print. Oh, wait. Here's some more. So if I run this and then go back out to my output.txt. Whoa, I am sorry. Oh, that snuck up on me. Okay, so then I say, here's some more. Oh, wait, here's some more. That prints out on the same line because I did a print instead of a print line. It's very unprofessional to just sneeze in the middle of the... But, you know, being professional, why start now? I need to put punctuation on my sentence. So it's going to stay on the same line because I did a print instead of a print line. So if I come back here and make turn these into print lines, then it will print and go down to the next line to be printed. And so if I run that to the output, then it's printing information out to the file. All right, and we could go into more detail, but I actually want to keep it fairly simple with this. It doesn't need to be any more complicated than that. We open the file we're printing out to, and then just like we'd print down to here, we print out to the file, and then in the end we close the file, and that's how we print out to a file. Very simple, very fun, and I think that's all. So we'll go ahead and end that there. Spencer out.